Luffy, the finance pirate and wannabe pirate king, whose bounty is 3 billion berries, one time woke up and told his crew, "Hey guys, I want to become a Pokemon master," to which they were like, "Dude, aren't you like trying to become pirate king and find the One Piece and all of that?" To which he replied, "Yeah, but it's been over 1,000 episodes, so I don't think anyone will complain if I take a little bit of extra time, would they?" So without any further thought, Luffy went straight into the Sinnoh region to meet Professor Roan. Professor Roan explained that becoming a Pokemon champion involves beating the gym leaders and champion of the Sinnoh region. He also offered Luffy a choice of 3 Pokemon to use, and Luffy, without any hesitation, picked Monkey D., the Chimchar. Starting to explore Sinnoh, Luffy realized there were many species of Pokemon to see. Birds, rodents, little plant things, and so much more. This is so cool! I'm already so looking forward to eating all of them after Sanji cooks them. And at this moment, Rowan's voice echoed in Luffy's head. "No, you don't eat the Pokemon. They are your friends and battle companions, dude." So Luffy settled for the next best thing and went to challenge gym leader Rourke. Monkey D., now a strong Monferno, took a page from his trainer's book and went on Rourke's team with a flurry of mock punches. One after the other, all of his Pokemon fell to Monferno, giving Luffy his first Pokemon gym badge. Luffy might have got a badge, but he realized most people traveled around with more than one Pokemon, and much like his own story, Monkey D. was never gonna make it to the top without a strong crew to help him. Luffy traveled all the way to Eterna City and from there to Mount Coronet, where he found a Pokemon that caught his interest. "Look at this long-nosed thing!" Luffy threw a Pokeball, and thus Usopp joined the team. Luffy also managed to evolve Nosepass on accident while training him inside Mount Coronet, thus getting a powerful Probopass. With this improved roster, Luffy went to challenge the second gym leader, Gardenia. And this time around, Monkey D. took a page from not Luffy, but his brother, Ace's book. Monferno wielded the flames like no other, melting through Gardenia's grass types with ease and getting Luffy the second badge. With 2 badges at hand, Luffy kept exploring Sinnoh for more interesting Pokemon to add to his squad. He managed to get into Wayward Cave, which granted him Jinbei, the Ghibli, as well as TM26 Earthquake. Heading to Hearthstone, he also caught Zoro the Ralt, getting his Pokemon count to 4. Fantina, the city's gym leader, was the toughest Luffy and his gang faced thus far. He led once again with his trusty Monferno, who managed to dispatch the lead Duskull, but would not come near getting a fully sweep like the previous times. Haunter came in. Luffy switched to Usopp, which used Thunder Wave to cripple the ghost before going back into Monferno, which destroyed Haunter with yet more fire-type moves. Last but not least was Miss Magius. Luffy went to Usopp again, but it got confused, so he went Zoro and let him feint to a Shadow Ball to bring Usopp back safely. This time around, Fantina did not opt for the confusion, and Miss Magius got paralyzed successfully. From there, Usopp managed to keep throwing rocks at Miss Magius until it got him into healing range, which Luffy exploited to get Monferno back in and defeat the paralyzed Ace 1v1. 3 badges in, so far, so easy. Luffy and friends would then go on easy towards Alacyon Town. In the Lost Tower, they encountered Brook the Duskull, which Luffy caught for a 5th Pokemon. Not finding anything interesting in Alacyon, he just headed towards Veilstone, home of the 5th gym leader, Mayleme. Brook was used to beat Metasite 1v1 with some Shadow Sneak spam. Machoke then came in. Against the Machoke, Brook used Curse as the big fighter used Focus Energy. Then Luffy switched it out for Probopass on a Rock Throw, then back to Brook on a Force Palm. This back and forth, switching allowed Luffy's Pokemon to remain safe as Curse killed the Machoke. Last was Lucario, which Usopp was sacrificed on and Jinbei was brought to tank a Force Palm and Earthquake for the one-shot. 5th badge in, and the team still rocks. Luffy, wasting absolutely no time, headed south to Pastoria City, where he'd find its gym leader, Crasher Wake. Well, his Monkey D., despite having unlocked the Gear 5 by becoming an Infernape, would definitely not be able to swim with the water Pokemon, so this one would have to be handled with care. Luffy led with Zoro, which traced Gyarados' Intimidate and got some chip before falling. Luffy sent in Jinbei, which 1v1 the weakened Gyarados with Dragon Claws. Wake then sent his Ace Floatzel, which proceeded to shred Jinbei with Ice Fang. Luffy sent in Usopp, which tanked a super effective brine to Thunder Wave the mighty water type. It then went to spam Rock Slide for as long as it could before fainting, getting into heal range. Luffy sent in Infernape and clicked Close Combat as Wake healed, almost a one-shot. Luffy switched then, fearing Aqua Jet would kill his ace Pokemon, Brook, however, received a Brine instead and easily used Shadow Sneak to beat Floatzel. Last was Quagsire. Brook used Curse, which at first made it nervous, since it means Quag was gonna kill him. But then, he remembered, he was already dead! Once Brook fell, Infernape easily won the battle with a Grass Knot, Gardenia's TM move giving Luffy his 5th badge. Luffy would then travel north all the way to Celestic Town, defeat a few bad guys he totally did not care enough to listen what they were up to, and was gifted HMO 3 Surf, which would allow him to cross water and get access to more of the Sinnoh region. But in typical reckless Luffy fashion, Luffy, who is supposed to be a pirate, did not consider having a ship to sail on thus far, so he searched for a Pokemon he would use and caught Sunny the Shellos, who then he would evolve into Gastrodon, which would not only grant him a way to cross water, but a final Pokemon for his team. He would also use his newfound surfing ability to go get a Dawnstone in Mount Coronet, evolving Zoro into Gallade. With a full team and massive confidence, Luffy went on to tackle the mighty Byron, which turns out is not nearly as mighty as one would think. Jinbei one-shot Magatun, Sunny one-shot the Steelix, and Monkey D. one-shot the Bastiodon, granting the Sunny crew their 6th badge. Luffy would then meet Professor Roan, defeat some bad guys who had goals Luffy most certainly did not care about, and then go on his merry way to get another gym badge, this time courtesy of Candace, the Ice-type Master. Luffy led with Monkey D, one-shotting both Sneasel and Piloswine with nasty close combats. Candace then sent her ace Frostlass, which Luffy responded to by going to his own Ghost-type, Brook. After some back and forth ghost type attacks, Frostlass came on top, leading Luffy to go Usopp. Usopp was first bamboozled by the ghost using double team to evade its attacks, but then in a valiant act of marksmanship, he finally landed a rock slide, vanquishing the ace Pokemon of the gym leader. Last was Abomasnow, at which Luffy sent Zoro, which barely failed to win the 1v1, but Monkey D was more than able to make up for it with a final fighting type attack, winning the 7th badge. Luffy was one gym badge away from being eligible for the final challenge that is the Elite Four, or he would have been if Jinbei did not just evolve into Garchomp, which just soloed the so-called best gym leader in all of Sinnoh by spamming one stupid base 100 stab move. Well, that was anticlimactic. But anticlimactic gym leaders aside, it was finally time for Luffy's Pokemon Master to be truly put to the test. 5 of the best trainers in all of the region, including champion Cynthia herself, stood in the pirate's way. So, Luffy knew what he needed to do, and Eren was the first man on the bounty list. Usopp was sent first, but Yanmega kept using double team, and despite Usopp's marksmanship, he was not able to win what would usually be a trivial type matchup. Those Pokemon League trainers were definitely not messing around. Brook went in next and used Curse to guarantee a way to beat this evasion boosted Yanmega, then Sunny would go and stall it out, having Eren send in Heracross and one-shot the weakened Gastrodon. This was tough. Luffy, however, would not be deterred so easily. He sent in Zoro and hit a nasty critical hit Psycho Cut for the one-shot. Next was Drapion, which had Luffy switch to Chomp and one-shot with EQ, before going on to sweep the remaining Scizor and Vespiquen. The Elite Four's first battle might have started poorly, but Luffy and his crew were getting the hang of this. Next up was Bertha, which Luffy led with Infernape for. Two Grass Knots were enough to beat lead Whiscash, who only Sandstormed in the meantime. Gliscor was next. Luffy went to Sunny, tanking an EQ. Sunny then proceeded to tank a second one of those and retaliate with a quad effect of Ice Beam for the one-shot, inviting in Hippowdon. Hippowdon easily defeated Sunny with Stone Edge. Jinbei was brought next. A back-and-forth EQ contest would put Hippo into the red, predicting the heal from Bertha. Luffy went to Brook and used a combination of Curse and Will-O-Wisp to cripple the Hippo monster and weaken it. From that position, all was left to do for Luffy was send his ace Infernape, which Grass Knotted not only the Hippo, but Golem and Rhyperior as well, one-shotting everything in sight. And speaking of one-shots, Flint's team consists of 5 Pokemon weak to ground, and Luffy has a Garchomp. 1 kill, 2 kills, 3 kills, 4 kills, and 5. 3 done, 2 to go. The Jinbe lead would also be used against the Psychic-type specialist Lucian. One-shotting his lead Mr. Mime with a crunch, another crunch would secure the second KO against Espeon, though this time Jinbe caught a Psychic in the process. Next up was Bronzong. Luffy withdrew Jinbe for Infernape as the bell used Calm Mind. Infernape then used Flare Blitz for the one-shot on Bronzong. Next up was Alakazam, which outsped and KO'd Monkey D. Luffy would then send Brook, which 1v1 Zam with a Shadow Punch into Shadow Sneak combo. More Shadow Sneaks were used to chip Gallade down before Brook fainted, but the battle was already over. Jinbe would come again, and one EQ was all it took. Only the champ was left, and Luffy was more determined than ever. Against the champ, Usopp was the lead. It managed to paralyze and dent the Ghost lead very significantly before switching out for Jinbe, finishing it with an EQ. Next was Cynthia's own chomp, which had Luffy sacrifice his Probo Pass and bring Sunny. Sunny barely took a stabby Q to the face and Ice Beam for the kill, but Chomp survived and proceeded to beat the Sunny. Luffy sends Zoro next, who managed to artfully dodge a Dragon Rush and score a kill with close combat. Togekiss came in. Luffy switched Zoro out for Brook, who barely managed to put a curse on Togi before falling. From there, Zoro would protect to get more damage out of the curse than kill with a close combat. Lucario was next. Lucario used a super effective Shadow Ball, which Gallade tanked before one-shotting the fellow fighting type with close combat. Milo then came in. Zoro would get its final contribution in this fight by chipping the mighty Sea Snake down with another CC. From there, Luffy sent his ace, the one and only Gear 5 Monkey D. Close combat killed the Milo and Roserade. Cynthia's final Pokemon fell to a Flare Blitz. Luffy had done it. He became the champion of the Sinnoh region and a true Pokemon master. He got to see and do something new, and now it was time for him to go back to his crew and find that stupid One Piece once and for all. Thanks for watching this video. We hope you enjoyed it. Please tell us in the comment section below if there's any other character you'd like to see play some Pokemon. And as always, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. Have a great one.